All right, guys, me and Ellie are back with another episode of Ousama Ranking. We have episode 14 here, up and ready to go. So, last episode, we had a lot of shit going on. We had, what was it? Dorish lost a leg, which is great, perfect, awesome. Boji, he's on his way to help Dorish and Hailing. I hope he makes it there with, you know, no issues. Prince O something. But the weird villain dude, he's on a massacre. And hopefully, you know, the guards can kind of stall him a bit until Despa shows up. So, yeah, that's really all I can remember. Like, Miranjo got stolen, but I don't really give a shit about that. It's like, you know, it's Miranjo. We don't care about her that much yet, anyway. So, yeah. What do you think? You want to just get right into the episode? Yeah? Okay. Let's go. Dorsh. Now I can really... Oh, shit. What? Oh, what? Did that help him to, like... Ma'am? Did that help him to, like, get free? Like, since it was one less limb they were holding down, he was like, oh shit, finally. Get a bit of leg room here. I don't need your judgment, Ellie. Ooh, got the eye, shit. Yeah, that's... Oh! If I fall here, man's still going, though! Oh! It just makes him stronger! Hailing's like, oh shit! Is he the monster? Damn! King Boss? Oh? Yeah, break that shit. Come on, man! You know you care about Hailing. Oh yeah, is he just gonna fucking, like, open the door? No problem. Yep. Oh, he's so, like... he's so torn between his love for Miranjo and his love for, like, Hailing and his family. Of course, what he's doing is shitty, but at least I can understand it. Because he knew Miranjo, like, for longer than he knew either of his wives. Because he's been with her for that long. So, of course, he, like, has feelings for her. He probably wants to, like, stick to the plan and, you know, make her happy. But it's also, like, come on, man. You have a wife. You must have loved at least a little bit, considering that reaction. So it's like, you really want her to die? You think Miranjo is in the right here? It's like, no. Stick it to her. Be like, hey, bitch, let this wife of mine live, please. It's like, she at least owes you that. Probably part of him understands, though, that, like, Hailing is holding him back and his, you know, his sons. And maybe part of him just really wants to still become the strongest. So it's kind of this internal battle. But I gotta say, I do love when Dorish was, like, pinned down. Miranjo was like, okay, that looks like it's it. Let's get out of here. And then Dorish just, he's like, oh shit. You know, now I can go free. Let's go. I'm back at it, baby. Like, man is just tough as hell. I bet that didn't even stop him. Man's like, I'm still good. Yeah, please run away. This is the problem, Hailing. There has been, like, three or four separate occasions where someone, like, sacrifices something, and they're like, Hailing, run. And she's just like... Like, I haven't forgotten. Like, I know one of them was to, like, save Anne. And I respect that. But it's like, get Anne and get the hell out of here. Oh, but she wants to help. Oh, I'm so mixed. I'm so mixed on, like, all these things, bro. Yo, Boji. Oh, yeah. Giving him more strength. Yes. That's right. That's right. Where you been, buddy? So he actually owes her too. That's probably why he peeled up, right? Unless Bebin put him up to it. This task is mine. I mean, I respect it. I really appreciate it. But you couldn't have showed up like 5 minutes ago before the leg was lost. Like maybe when Doris was like pinned down to the ground, like right before the leg got bit. I shouldn't complain. Hell yeah, Heiling. Hell yeah. Can she actually heal like that much? She's chugging back the juice. Oh, damn, making the flowers grow and shit. Yo, if we see this man's leg, like, grow back, I'll be stunned. Oh, I think the eye's better. Oh, no. Okay, yeah. Oh, so that makes sense. Yeah, so I'm guessing, just from seeing the eye, he didn't get his eye back, but, like, the scar, you know, grew over. So, probably the same with the leg, probably just the flesh mended. He still don't have a leg. It's magic, but it ain't that magic, you know. Oh, really? Yeah, he is apparently a really strong dude. Oh. No, Mara. Damn. Was that Boji? That sounded really small. Or was that Anne throwing something? Kage! Oh, he's so sad. He's like, no, my friend. Oh, can she though? Can she? She just healed Doris for so much. Is she gonna be able to? He's not actually. Is he dying? Oh, is this shit he stole? Is this shit like he stole way back when? That's the only thing I can think of. Mata. Okay, sorry. I was thinking his name was Mitsumura, but no, it's Mata. Mitsumata. that's cute. That's cute that they're copying. They're helping. Don't you worry, boys. Oh no, Boji, turn around, bud. No, Boji, you're supposed to be a good fighter. Look, have perspective, buddy. Yeah, come on. Oh, man didn't even have to, like, he wasn't even in a hurry. He's like, yo, chill, dude. You really want to do this? Oh, man's going on about the atoms. Oh, right. Oh, shit. Can this man... Can he, like, see the atoms and the particles? Damn. Hey, yo, keep healing. Yo, you got a job to do here. You don't gotta be worried. Yeah, that's right, buddy. Go to sleep. Yeah, that's right. You know, you just saw that. Yo, I like that Heiling saw that, but she should really keep healing. Like, that's what I'm worried about. Mitsumata still might be in pain back there. What is this? Oh. Yeah, Boji trying to help. Come on, man. He's better now. This is a flashback to before everything's happened. So I will let it go. But that makes me mad. Because it's like Boji, he just wants to help. And he is helping. That little bit of water, that even if it's tiny, that is still doing something, right? It's better than it not being there. Like, how is he slowing you down? Walk around him. I'm sure Boji, he's probably like good enough at this point to be able to tell, like, okay, I'm going to be in his way. I'll just step over this way a bit. He's like, he's doing his own thing. Yeah, but like, you all can do your own thing. It's like, come on. It's not like Daita is better because he can have a bigger bucket, right? They're both helping in their own way. Yeah. That's about what I expected from Boss. See, it's different when you think, like, the only reason Boss can do that is because he stole Boji's power. Boji might have been able to do that. He might have gotten damn near close enough. Might have been stronger than Daita, but got screwed over. Yep. Came a long way, though. Ah, yay! Oh, yeah. I wonder, like, I guess, well, Heiling would have been there to hug Daita too, right? And it's not like Daita is so, like, cold-hearted. He kind of was. But he would have had Heiling. Boji had two mothers to, you know, show him that, you know, there's people who care about him. Daita only had Heiling. I really, for some reason, I doubt Boss was much of a hugger. So yeah, I guess, you know, Boji just got double the kindness, so of course he's going to be a nicer person. An evil aura. Yo, that's kind of mean to say right when you met him. Jesus. Yo, if I was Kage, I'd be like, yo, bitch, I just saved your ass. I helped. Oh, damn, I didn't think he was actually going to say it. It's true. He's got a point. Exactly. Yeah, oh, he's crying. He's like, damn, have I not done enough to deserve Boji's, like, friendship? Like, what, you want to take it from me? After everything I've done for this man? Heiling. Like, you know, I understand. Sensing an evil aura, that's just a thing that comes with, you know, the Shadow Clan type deal. But it is still so mean to say that, like, right to this guy who helped to save you. It's like, come on, Heiling, you got a bit of work to do, okay? While explaining my position. Ah, can't do it herself. Yeah, but that's not fair, though, right? Well, like, sure, he has done... He's just done what he needs to do to survive. That's why he's done stuff that, you know, is mistrustful. Well, I don't... He's never done anything to, like... Well, I guess right at the beginning of the series, he was, like, using Boji to steal stuff. But that's, like, the worst of anything he's done, right? He's stolen from people, but it's not like he's hurt or killed anybody. He hasn't been, like, an assassin. Or, like, some of his other Shadow Clan. So, like, I'd say he's still good. I mean, it's not like everyone else is an angel, right? Other than Boji. Aww. That's cute. Okay, good. Oh, it's because, you know, it's a motherly feeling, right? Which he's missing. Boji feels bad about them. Nice, Boji. Me too, man. Me too. Maybe her healing will like knock the hypnotizing out of him. I hope. Yeah. Okay, they're back to normal. Let's go. Aw, come on. He just wants to say thank you. Oh, well, that did a lot of good. Oh, I wonder. Because this guy seems to respond to strength, right? Because I remember when we first saw him, he was being led around by Kingbo. And I take it that that's because Kingbo is like was stronger than him. So I wonder if he'll actually follow Boji now. Yeah, he's nervous. He's like, oh shit, I don't want to go against this man again. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, we got this guy on our side now? Bless. Acknowledging the first one of the first times, right, that someone has acknowledged his strength. Yeah, now he can. For friends. Yeah. None of that master shit with Bodhi. My majestic. Right. Maybe he has to take on some of that kingly stuff. Yeah, but Boji wants to be a different kind of king, right? Look at this. We went for in the beginning of this episode, it was like Dorsch and Hailing versus everybody else here, other than, Boji and Kage. But look at it now. Everyone's on the same side. How does that even happen? Okay. Despot, what are you doing hiding like that, though? They could probably use some help right now. Yo. Man lost a limb. Oh, it's only him? Shit. And can he just grow that hand back? I swear. Oh my god, dude. That's ridiculous. Oh, I was gonna say, like, was this man Thor? Like, I thought he was controlling the lightning. Like, what kind of bullshit is this? Came too late. Yeah, like the whole freaking team's done. Nice. Nice, White King. Immortality. Yeah, so that dude. Leaving Osprey. Yeah, it's like what happens if you take that whole part of like living away is like the part where you have to worry about death and your legacy on everything. It's like if you don't have that, then you're just going to be a very like cold person. I don't know what happened because they're saying it like maybe he went after the power of immortality, like he wanted to live forever. Or maybe it just, something happened and it came to him. Like, yeah, it seems like that Auken guy was nice. Like he's the guy from the OP, like I thought. He was that dude. So I don't know like if he got possessed by this immortality shit or if it just straight up turned him evil. Well, oh shit though. Shit though. Because that means that they're gonna run into like what is that man's name? Like Hokuto and why am I forgetting his name? Starts with a D. Domus. Domus. So they might run into them because like they found the portal, and I assume it takes them. It goes two ways because we've seen Maranzo take it back. So I'm guessing that might be how they sneak into the kingdom, and they're gonna try to take it over that way. Is through, coming up through the portal and taking shit over. So, yeah, it's not looking great. Hopefully, Domus and Hokuto can maybe hold them off. I don't know. They're not that good of fighters, though, to go up against, like, the underworld. Well, I guess Domus is pretty good. Hokuto, he's got the crossbow, so he can stay at range. But I mean, Deysa's got lightning. I think that beats a crossbow. I'm just guessing. So yeah, that's not looking great for like the kingdom. But everything else, everything else in that episode, that was good. We learned a little bit about, you know, Prince Aukin there. I don't know. He used to be a good guy, and then he got immortality somehow. Maybe he just, you know, got turned evil just from time of like, I don't know, because it is weird that we've seen moments where like he's scared and then all of a sudden he gets the courage and does some fucked up shit. So I don't really understand it. I'm sure we'll get more explanation in the future, but for some reason I doubt that they're straight up gonna like, I don't know, because Prince Aukin, he's done some fucked up shit now, especially like now, because he massacred that whole town last episode, or part of the town, sorry. So I don't know if they'd have like a redemption arc for him, but if he's being like possessed or something and can be turned good again, they might try to do that. But then if he was a good dude, he might feel a whole lot of like bad about what he did. So I don't know. I feel bad. Like right now, I don't like the character of Aukin, but how they talk about him, like how he was in the past, and we saw a flashback where he was like, I just want to create a world of like, you know, peace type shit, that the normal stuff. He seemed like a good dude. Just why he would have went after immortality or anything like that, I don't know, yet to be explained. But yeah, I'm going to wait to hold judgment too hard on like Aukin, his character as a whole. But the shit he's done so far, he cannot really be forgiven. So I don't know. It's a very, like I said, there was a lot of mixed things I'm feeling right now in the whole episode. Because, you know, we saw Boss also. He wanted to help Hailing, but he couldn't. Because he was thinking of Miranjo. He's like, no, Miranjo wants me to stay and go through with this. That's what I'll do. Even though he had that one little moment where he was like breaking out. He was like, shit, I need to help Hailing. She needs my help. But then he turned around and it's like, no, Boss, it's your wife, dude. Who, like, Miranjo, I get it. Been with her for a long time. Probably like so in love with her. But obviously you love Hailing too. And it's fucked up to just abandon her like that. I don't know how to feel about his character. I'm sure he'll get a bit of redemption too, because he seems like he's not, you know, fully forgone. He's not a evil person. He's just doing some bad shit right now. Some bad decisions. But yeah, the main focus of this episode was like, you know, Boji showing up, showing everybody who's boss now. And that's it. Showed Hailing what he's got, showed Dorsh what he's got. They both respect him even more now, which is kind of fucked up because, like, he was a prince. You should already respect him. But no, they did. They did, but, like, in more of a nurturing way. They didn't let him, like, do his own thing. Like, in that flashback, Daita said, don't do your own thing. You're only getting in the way. I'm sure he did that somewhat out of caring for his brother, because he's like, you know, I don't want you to get hurt. You're not really doing much for the team. Maybe just stand back. He said it in a really mean way, but I'm guessing there was maybe like a hint of, you know, brotherly love in there. And the same goes to like Hailing and everyone else from the castle. They all cared about Boji. They just, you know, they didn't think he was capable of fending for himself. But now he's able to prove them wrong on that. And he's getting the respect that he rightfully deserves. I was a little salty when Hailing said, like, oh, you're royalty, you need to start acting like it, like that sort of thing. And it's like, but you didn't treat him like royalty. That it's your fault that he's like that, that he's not, you know, confident yet. That part kind of bugged me. But I get where she's coming from, because she knows he can actually like handle himself now. And no point in like bringing up the past like that. It's like she's acknowledging him. He gets it. Everyone gets it. And I do really, 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 really respect that Boji wanted her to heal up those monsters even after everything they've done. He didn't know like if they would still start attacking them or whatever. He just wanted them to be better. Like Dorsch was only fighting them out of self-defense, right? He didn't want to kill them, I don't think, but he had to. And luckily, he didn't kill them. Not fully. They were able to get healed. And I don't know if it was the near-death thing or the healing thing that knocked them from Miranjo's control. But either way, I'm glad they're okay, because we saw that they had, like, cubs and shit, and Miranjo just stole them. That's the thing. Like, Miranjo, I'm very mixed on her, too, because I realize we're probably going to get some backstory from her, because we've seen it in the OP. She's, like, we've seen her as, like, a kid, and she has, like, a monster, like, wrapping its hand around her eyes, like, both her child version and the adult version. So I feel like she might even be getting controlled in some way to do this, or she's just really, like, she's got the whole wrong, like, perspective. She's thinking about things completely wrong, that type of thing. So I feel like we might get a bit of redemption from her, or maybe just, you know, understand her better. But she is doing some fucked up shit too. She took those monsters who didn't want to fight, and made them fight for her to the death, some of them. And same with, like, she broke out a bunch of evil villains, and one of them straight up went and, like, massacred part of the town. And it's like, is that forgivable? Like, she's doing all this for her own gain, for Boss's gain too, but it's kind of selfish still on her part. So it's like, I don't know. Everyone's doing some fucked up stuff, and I have a feeling they're going to make us, like, they're going to give us backstory on those characters, and I don't know how I'm going to feel. Like, I'm all for forgiveness, but there's an extent, right? Like, they've murdered people. They've gotten people killed. It's like, is that okay? I don't know. Because when I think of that, I also think of, like, Heiling. Because Heiling was going to kill Hokuto a few episodes ago because she thought Boji was dead. But that is kind of how, like, the royal shit worked back then, right? Like, if you failed the royal family, you died. But still, that doesn't feel right. You know, like, Hokuto's a good dude. He apologized. He said, it's my fault, blah, blah, blah. And Heiling was still pissed. She was like, execute this man. So, like, every character seemed, even if they're, like, a really nice, caring character, they still do some dumb shit. I think that's kind of what the show is trying to put across. It's like, nobody's perfect, right? I don't know, though, because, like, maybe I'm thinking too far ahead of it for now. We'll just have to wait and see, like, what they do with those characters. Just, I know I'm going to be really mixed if they do throw in, like, a redemption arc for, like, Miranjo or Elkin, either of those two. We didn't get to see any of the other villains, though, this episode, other than Gigan. And I do like Gigan. I like that he's on our side now. We haven't seen him do anything too fucked up. He did almost kill Dorsch, but, you know, he was also, he responds to strength. He was just following the strong, and now he's following the strong again. I don't like that level of loyalty, because that just means, like, if someone's stronger than Boji peels up, he'll just follow them. So, skeptical. I'm skeptical about that. But still, I like that we have him on our side now. He's a nice little addition to the team. And yeah, the other criminals, I don't know. They're doing something with Miranjo's mirror, I take it. And we'll probably see Kingbo back, because we saw he was still alive a little bit. Might not be for a few more episodes, though. It is only episode 14. So, yeah. Anyway, though, great episodes. I think I talked about everything that I wanted to. It was, you know, every episode lately has been really good. I'm really enjoying this. Like, ever since the new OP got introduced, these episodes have been bangers. Not saying the ones before that were, like, bad, but, you know, these ones have all been really exciting. They've had something going on, like some kind of fight or whatever. So I'm really enjoying this later half so far. And I hope it sticks with this, because it's good. It's really good. Anyway, though, that's going to be it for this episode. So if you guys enjoyed, be sure to drop a like, subscribe to the channel, comment down below your thoughts, anything you want to say about, like, the video, the episode, the series, whatever your thoughts are. Let me know. Just no spoilers. I also do have a Patreon linked down below in the description that you can go to if you want to support me. It just gives you early access to the videos. And yeah, I'd appreciate it if you check that out. And yeah, that's everything. So I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day. And I'll talk to you all later. Peace.